Hello everyone. Today we will talk about Azure Blob Storage on IoT Edge. What is it? It is a lightweight Azure consistent module which provides blob storage. It comes with configurable ability to automatically upload the data to Azure and provide support for intermittent internet connectivity. It also has the ability to automatically delete the data from the local blob storage account. What all we will learn today? How to configure and deploy this module? Auto-tiering and auto-expiration functionalities in action. Auto-tiering in a disconnected scenario. How will we doing it? We already have an Azure IoT Edge device running Azure IoT Edge runtime. We will deploy Azure Blob Storage on IoT Edge module, pointing to Edge local blob storage account. We will install Azure Storage Explorer in a desktop and connect it to our local storage account and Azure Storage account. Then we will upload data to our local blob storage account via Azure Storage Explorer and check out auto-tiering in action. Sounds good? Let's get started. Number one, how to configure and deploy this module with auto-tiering and auto-expiration functionality. For this demo, we will be using VS Code. We have an Azure IoT Edge device running Azure IoT runtime. We added this section. Let's call our module local storage. Provide the link to the MCR URL. Provide a name to your local storage account. Provide local storage account key and storage path. Now, let's configure auto expiration and auto tiering as desired properties for this module. Auto expiration is your TTL settings. Set TTL on to true to turn on this feature. Time to live in minutes is set to 30 minutes. It means the module will delete the blob from local blob storage account after 30 minutes of its last modified time. Auto tiering is your tiering settings. Set tiering on to true to turn on this feature. The backlog policy is set to oldest first. It means my oldest data will be uploaded first. Remote storage connection string expects connection string to your Azure storage account where the data will be uploaded. Tier containers property allow you to specify the source and target container names. In this example, we are saying upload the data of cont 1 in local blob storage account to Edge cont 1 in Azure blob storage. Similarly for cont 2. For cont 3, you can see I have not provided the target container name. Hence, the module will automatically assign it one. Let's go ahead and deploy this module. Now, let's refresh. Here is our module. Let's make sure it's reflected in Azure portal as well. I have downloaded and installed Azure Storage Explorer 1.5.0 version. Let's connect it to our local storage account. I'll show the connection string format on the screen. Let's create container cont 1 in local storage account. Similarly, I created cont 2 and cont 3. Number 2. It's time to see auto-tiering and auto-expiration in action. I have connected my Azure storage account as well. Let's make sure I don't have any pre-existing containers. Now, let's add an image to cont 1 in the local blob storage account. Wait for a while and refresh. The image magically appears in our Azure storage account. Let's make sure of it in Azure portal. If you remember, we didn't provide target name for cont 3. Let's see what happened when we added some files to cont 3. The files appeared in container in Azure whose name is automatically assigned by our module. If you remember, I have set time to live in minutes to 30 minutes. Now, let's check the last modified time of our files in the local storage account. I'll skip ahead to 30 minutes and see what happens. The blobs are automatically getting deleted from the local storage account once their time to live in minutes expires. Number 3, let's see auto-tiering in a disconnected scenario. I'm adding two big files of roughly 1.5 GB each to our local storage account. After it is added to the local storage account, let's wait for a while and disconnect the internet from the IoT device. Let's wait for a while and reconnect the internet. The module automatically figured out that the internet connection is back again and started uploading the blobs. And here are my two big files in Azure. For more up-to-date information, go to this URL. Thanks for watching.